Hey, Angular folks, it's Brian. After many years of building with Angular, I'm here to help you level up your skills and build better apps. You've probably built a layout component in Angular, maybe a card or a panel, tossed in a few content slots, and called it a day. But then things get weird. What happens when you need more than one slot in a component? And what happens when you have a conditional slot and none gets passed in? Or when you want the same projected slot to appear in two different places, conditionally, depending on the layout? That's what this video is all about. By the end, you'll know how to build layout components that adapt to what's passed into them and only render what they need. Let's make our components a little smarter. Here's what we're starting with. A pretty basic card component. It renders some projected content, but nothing fancy. No header, no actions, just the raw content passed inside. It's just a basic presentation component that can be used in a lot of different ways. In this tutorial, we're going to add some additional content regions to this component to provide even more flexibility. But before we do, let's look at the code to get a better understanding of what's going on. Right now, we've got a generic ngContent directive. This acts like a placeholder. It's where any content passed between the opening and closing card component tags will show up. Okay, now let's switch to the main app component to see how this component is used. Here, you can see we're projecting some generic HTML, a heading, paragraph, and a mark tag into the content region for our card component. And that's what shows here. This is basic content projection. Whatever you place between the component tags gets rendered where ngContent is. Okay, now that we understand everything here, we want to add a title region to this component also using content projection. But how can we do this since we already have a generic slot in our component? Well, let's open back up the template and I'll show you. First, let's start by adding another ngContent directive. But this time, we're going to set it up to select something more specific with the select attribute. This allows us to project a specific piece of content into this slot using a CSS selector. Let's use an H3 here. This tells Angular only project the H3 element here. Skip everything else. Now, in order to make this look a little better, we'll wrap it in a div with the card header class. Then we'll also add a checkmark icon to give it a little more visual pop. Okay, now let's go back into the app component and actually give this card a title. Here, let's add an H3 with the title above our other content. Now let's save and take a look. Boom! Our title is now neatly wrapped in that styled header section. We're on our way. Now I want to add yet another slot. This one will be for an actions region in the bottom of this card, for buttons like edit, learn more, save, etc. Here, we have a navigation component already created, and this is what we want to project into this new region. So, let's open back up the card component template. Below the body, let's add another div, this time with the card actions class. Then, within this div, we'll add another ngContent directive. This time, we'll select on the app navigation element. Okay, now that we have a slot, let's head back into the app component. Now, before we can use the navigation component, we need to import it in our component's imports array. Okay, now we can add this component within our card. Then let's add an edit button. And let's add a complete button and make it a type submit. That should be all we need here, so let's save and see how it looks. There it is. Our new footer region with action buttons. Looks good, right? So this is pretty cool. We can easily add multiple different slot regions in our components when needed. But a lot of the time, when we have layout components like this, the slots may be optional. We may have a header in one case, but not in another. But now we have markup surrounding these slots. So what happens if the slot is not used? Well, let's comment out the H3 and find out. Okay, so right now, even if I remove the content, the container still shows up. That's not ideal. But good news, this can be fixed. Let's switch over to the TypeScript for the card component. Here, we're going to add a property to check if the header slot exists or not that we can then use in our template. Let's call it header. Then, since the elements projected into this component are considered its content, we can use a content child signal query. In this case, it will be an element, and we'll look for an element with an alias of header, which we'll see more on in a minute. So, this sets up a reactive signal called header. It'll return the element if something with the template reference of header is projected into the component. Otherwise, it'll be null. This means that we can now switch over to the template and then wrap the header markup in an if block based on this signal. So now this section should only render if the header signal is truthy. Let's save and see. Nice. Since we don't have a header at the moment, we no longer see the header markup either. Now let's switch back over and uncomment the header. What we need to do now, in order to be recognized by the content child function, is we need to add a header template reference variable here. Okay, now let's save and see how it looks. And there it is. The wrapping markup is back. So this is cool, but needing to remember the reference variable might be a little annoying. You can do it this way, but it's probably a little awkward. Let's comment back out this H3. Next, let's do the same for the navigation section, but in this case, it'll be a little different, maybe even a little better actually. First, let's comment out the navigation component and save. Yep, the footer container still shows up, empty and sad. Let's switch back over to the TypeScript for the card component. Now we'll add another content child signal, this time for the navigation component, so we can use the class as the selector. Then we can switch over to the template. Here we can update the footer container to only render if this signal is truthy. Okay, that's it. Let's save and see. Nice. Now the navigation wrapper disappears too. Okay, let's uncomment this again. Now, what if we need a slot in multiple different locations conditionally in the template? Like, what if I want this navigation section to show up where it does only when the header is included, but when the navigation is included without the header, it is included in the body region? Well, let's switch over to the template and try this out. Let's duplicate the navigation slot inside the card body, but wrap it in an if block to only show if there's no header. Then let's update the original section to only show when there is a header. So now it's mutually exclusive. Only one should show depending on the header's presence. Okay, let's save and try this out. Nice. In this case, we have no header, so the buttons are included right with the body content. Let's switch back over and add the header back. Bummer. Now we're not actually getting any buttons. This is the problem with how we have this slot included twice. What happens in this case is that the first slot encountered is the one that gets rendered. But in this case, that slot isn't actually rendered, because the condition is false. This is why we don't actually see any buttons. But there is a fix. Let's switch back to the card template. Now, let's move this slot into an ng template. And let's give it a reference variable of nav actions. Okay, now we can switch these over to use an ng container with an ngTemplateOutlet, where we reference the variable for our template. and we need to update both spots. Then we just need to switch over to the TypeScript and add the ngTemplateOutlet directive to our component imports. Okay, now let's save and try it again. Nice, now everything works exactly as expected. If we have a header, we have the navigation in a footer container. If we don't, the buttons move in with the body. Now this component is a lot more flexible, right? And that's it. We've gone from a basic card component to something way more flexible, adaptive, and just smarter. We covered how to create multiple name slots with ngContent, control their rendering with contentChild, and reuse them across your layout with ngTemplateOutlet. These small patterns go a long way in making your components more flexible, cleaner, and easier to use. If this helped, give it a like and subscribe for more Angular tips and tricks. Until next time, thanks for watching.